Hi, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. In an earlier video, I explained how to control the colour balance of this image using Capture One. A few people have since been in touch to say they would really like to see me complete the editing. I said in that video that the raw conversion in Capture One was only my first step, which seems to have made some people wonder what else I could do. So in this video, I'm going to take the image into Photoshop to complete my editing using the Nik Collection and a few other Photoshop tools. The idea I have is to enhance the colour of the sky and the heather further. I then want to apply some dodging and burning to make the heather more obvious. After that, I'll add a slight dreamy effect to selected areas of the image, although I'm not sure yet how I want to use it. I'll start by duplicating my background layer and then converting it to use with smart filters. Because I'm working with the Nik Collection tools, a smart filter layer will retain my adjustments in case I want to tweak them later. With the layer converted for smart filters, I can launch Nik Color Effects Pro. The first filter I'm going to add in Nik Color Effects is Pro Contrast, which I'm going to use to selectively clean the colours in some areas. I've previously published a couple of videos about the techniques I'll be using in this video. If you want to know more, I'll include the links in the YouTube video description. I'm now going to add a second Pro Contrast filter, which I'll use to enhance the detail in the heather using the Dynamic Contrast Adjustment. Here, I'm using a positive control point to select the heather. But because the selection spills over into other areas, I'll add negative control points to help remove the effect from those. When I'm happy with the editing, I'll apply the changes and return to Photoshop. Next, I'm going to work with Nik VFX to adjust some of the colours and tones in the image. First, I want to enhance the warm colours in the sky using a control point in the warmth slider. To make the warm colours stand out further, I'll use another control point on the corners of the sky and then boost the blue colour. I can do this using the blue and saturation sliders. Because this is starting to look a little bit purple in some areas, I'll also reduce the red slider. Now I want to do what I call exposure balancing, which is another technique I've covered in previous videos. All I'm doing is selecting areas with a control point and then adjusting the brightness and contrast to help lead the viewer's eye. Later, I'll probably do some additional dodging and burning in Photoshop where I have a little bit more control. My next change is to enhance the heather. I'll start by selecting the flowers on a clump of heather using a control point. This allows me to lighten them and to add some contrast and saturation to improve the colour. Using the warmth slider can also work well, but it may be necessary to reduce the level of red in the heather if it looks too pink. Once I'm happy with one control point, I can then duplicate it to other areas of heather. Notice how all the changes I'm making are quite subtle. I've tried to do most of the large changes in Capture One during the RAW conversion, and now what I'm trying to do is just refine them and add a final polish. Once I'm happy with the changes, I'll apply them and return to Photoshop. If I turn the smart filter off and on, you can see the impact the Nik filters are having. I'm now going to use dodging and burning to help emphasize the heather further. When I'm dodging and burning, I like to use a luminosity selection. I have several great tools that I could use for this, but in this video, I'm going to use TK Actions. I'm not doing this for any special reason other than I keep getting requests to show it. If you have Lumenzia or Raya Pro, you can do just the same thing. I'll start by adding a burn layer, which I'll use to darken some of the light shadows. To select the light shadow tones in the image, I'll use the zone selection option in TK Action's Rapid Mask. When I can see the areas I want to darken, displayed in white, I create a selection. Now I can paint through the selection onto the burn layer with the black paint to darken it. Then I can repeat the process using a dodge layer. This time I want to select the dark midtones, which I'll use to lighten the heather and make it stand out more. Having finished dodging and burning, I want to enhance the colours in the heather. Some areas aren't looking as vibrant or colourful as others. There are lots of techniques I could use to do this, but I'm going to use a simple one where I just paint onto a new empty layer. First, I'll add the new empty layer from the layer menu and then set the blending mode to vivid light. Now I'm going to zoom into an area of colour of the heather so that I can sample it. Then it's back to TK Actions to select the heather that I want to paint over. Now with the brush tool, I can paint colour onto the new layer through the selection I've made using TK Actions. you can see the difference this makes if I turn the layer off and then on. When I'm happy with the adjustment, I can clear my selection in the menu. Finally, I'm going to use a frequency separation to create a dreamy effect in the image. This is another technique I've covered previously, and I'll include the link in the YouTube video description. Rather than show you the long-winded manual way to do this, I'm going to use WOW Frequency Equalizer Pro and just click the Quick button. The radius value I'm entering is 26, which is the megapixel count of the camera I shot the image with. You can set any value, but I've found a pixel count is a good starting point for any dreamy effect. What the software's done is separate the colour and the detail in the image onto two separate layers. There's a high frequency layer which has the detail, and I can then soften that by reducing the opacity. Be careful not to reduce this too far or you end up with a blurred image. The colour and tones for the image are now on the low frequency layer, which I'll duplicate. I'll also reduce the opacity of the duplicate layer to 20% before I change the blending mode to soft light. This creates a nice effect, but I don't want to apply it to the darkest parts of the image. To control this, I'll create a mask for the group using TK Action's Rapid Mask. To create the mask, I'll use the Darks 4 selection and then just invert it. I can also refine the mask further by painting onto it with black in areas where I want to hide the effect. Or white, where I want to reveal more of the effect. Finally, I'll put all the layers into a folder. If I turn the folder visibility off and then on, you can see the overall effect of the adjustments I've made. Now for a note of caution. Please remember, if I was doing this to make a print, I'd probably take 10 times longer and use a lot more care. I'm rushing things here to make a video to demonstrate techniques. Hopefully though, it's given you some ideas and that it's shown you why I didn't feel that I'd created a finished image in Capture One. If you found this video helpful, please take a moment to share it. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.